Smart speakers are everywhere these days, coming out of just about every manufacturer out there, and this is LG's version, the WK7 ThinQ Smart Speaker. Let's check it out. When it comes to the design of the speaker, as you can see, it's not exactly inspired. It looks a little bit like a large Amazon Echo. It also has some HomePod in there, maybe a little Sonos one. So it's not exactly a unique design, but we do like it. It's pretty stylish, and although it's rather big, it will look good on your countertop. On the top of the speaker are some basic controls. You've got your volume control here, the function button, which switches between Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and of course the play pause button. And then there are some little inputs there for the microphones. The front here is a little LED setup that lets you know where the volume is and also lets you know when the speaker is listening. And then we like this at the back. There's actually a mute microphone button here.
The mic is muted.
Which allows you to shut the speaker down if you don't want it to hear what you're saying. Now, as we referenced, the WK7 is a Google Assistant speaker, and one thing we love about these speakers is they're really simple to set up. Basically, you just use the Google Home app, and it'll walk you right through it. Once you plug the speaker in, it should show it in the app, and then setting it up takes a matter of minutes before it's right there on your network. In testing, the WK7 is able to do all of the things you expect from a Google Assistant speaker, like turning on smart locks, turning on and off lights, and even asking questions on the internet, and it works quite well for these functions. Now, LG has partnered with Meridian Audio, a British audio company, for the sound for the WK7, and it has paid off. The WK7 offers some very solid performance, especially for a $200 speaker, with an emphasis on forward vocals and pretty powerful bass response as well. When it comes to overall size and power, the WK7 is somewhere in between the Google Home Max and the Apple HomePod. And although it can't match the fidelity of either of those speakers, it's also about half the price. When it comes to detail and instrumental definition, the WK7 also doesn't match up with the Sonos One, even though it does offer high resolution support. But then again, the Sonos One is one of the best sounding speakers on the market. While we like the sound overall, one of the things we noticed was that there's a lot of digital signal processing happening here, which can make instruments like horns and acoustic guitars sound less than natural. There's also a fair bit of compression, which allows LG to get the speaker very loud, but when you're listening to over-heavy bass tracks, it has a little problem keeping things even. Overall though, for $200, there's a lot of good sound here for the money, and it'll work really well as a background speaker. LG's first smart speaker is well-rounded in more ways than one, and those looking for powerful sound on a tight budget will want to give it a look. If you like this video, please let us know in the comments, and please also subscribe to the Digital Trends channel where you can see more content like this. And if you want to see the full review and tons of other reviews, please go ahead and check out digitaltrends.com.